I loved one of your things that you were quoted as saying. You said you are uninterested in shame. And tell me the process you went through in deciding to be transparent about this.
I think a big part of it was getting to a certain point, and there's always this breakthrough point where I said, why am I here? Am I here to be an actress?
Right.
To hope that someone doesn't think I'm too crazy to be hired? Or maybe my life is about something altogether different, and maybe I was trying to fit in the box of actress, and I was never meant to stay in that box. Yeah. Maybe I was meant to do something more, and for me, if all of this had to happen to me, in order for me to sit here across from Dr. Phil and talk about this, and someone watching in their home right now says, oh, I thought that there was something intrinsically wrong with me and that I was damaged. And maybe there is a way out. If that's what my life is about, I am more than happy to step into that.
Was it freeing for you?
The invisible chains are gone. You know, this is it. This is me.
And I want people to know, you've been diagnosed with dissociative identity disorder, correct?
Yes, sir.
If they haven't heard dissociative identity disorder, we're talking about what most people in common parlance would call split personality or multiple personalities. And when did you first get that diagnosis?
So I went into PTSD treatment, mm-hmm. and it was there that my memories of childhood sexual abuse that had been trapped in my mind for mm-hmm. 25 years. And the bubble burst on those memories. And in the process of this, the splitting that I had kind of lived with in a more subtle, unconscious way became very apparent. And I also experienced co-consciousness, where I was me and my 31, 32, whatever, you know, year it was, self, as well as my 6-year-old self, my 8-year-old self, a 13-year-old self would take the reins from me. And my 31-year-old self in my mind is like, talk about a war inside your own mind. Mm-hmm. I literally couldn't get back to the more present, grounded, hopefully somewhat more mature self of the 30-something-year-old from the 13-year-old.
You, in fact, discovered that you were sexually abused, molested for a 6-year period in your life from 5 to like 11, right?
Yes, sir.
This wasn't in your consciousness until 31. There's something called perceptual defense, where if there's something that overwhelms you, then our brain has the ability to put up a wall where we really don't perceive that. It's kind of like if someone is in a car wreck and they see their child go through a windshield or something horrible, and it's just more than they can process. They will actually put up a perceptual defense and have a functional blindness about that, and they won't remember seeing that, even though they saw it very clearly. And one of the coping mechanisms for some people is to create an altar that they can escape into while that's happening. Mm-hmm. And so that was in your history, but you didn't acknowledge it consciously until 31. When you look back now, can you see how it drove some of the personalities that you have lived with along the way?
Oh, absolutely. You know, my least favorite question on the red carpet as an actress was, what is your sense of style? Because one night I might want to wear leather and spikes, and right. another night I'm wearing a tutu, and then I might be a little bohemian chick. And I was just like, you know, I dress for my moods. I didn't know how to even articulate the differences, but they felt like strong moods, but they were moods I'd be in for right. weeks at a time. A relationship would bring out a mood, mm-hmm. and I would be that mood until I was no longer with that person and meet that person in a restaurant and I become that mood again. So because I had no awareness of this and might have been a little bit of an arrogant little brat in my early 20s, I just thought there was something wrong with everybody else. And I was like, well, you guys are just, you know, boring. I'm more interesting or something. Right. And I had this, of course, a defense mechanism, but I did always have the belief that if anyone ever really knew who I was, I would never be loved and I would always be alone.
Do you have a story or a question for me? Click the link in the description and tell me what in the world is going on.